Hey, what's up, fam? Today we're going to talk about what you should expect and what you should do before you receive your CCW license in Orange County, California. Hellcat. All right, guys. So today we're going to talk about what to do, what to expect before you get your license, your CCW license in Orange County. There's a few things that I recommend you should do. You put in your application, you are waiting for your classes, you're waiting for your interview. Right now, as of August 27th, 2020, the interview process is probably about a month to 2 months from the time you submit your application. So you have plenty of time to take care of things. So with that, before you get through all your interview and actually getting your license, there's a few things that I suggest you take care of before that happens. One is do your research and research carry insurance. I went with USCCA. That's what I feel is best for me. You may feel something else is better, but I think USCCA is the best in the industry. So research. Another thing to do is if you're not used to carrying a firearm, which if you're applying for your CCW for the first time, you're probably not. I recommend purchasing a holster and finding what holster feels comfortable for you. I would wear that holster throughout your day. I know there's not a firearm in it, but getting used to having that extra bulk in your pants, on whether it's appendix or on your side or on your back, is a different change throughout your day. It changes what you put in your pockets, how you put things in your pockets. So make sure you choose and look for a holster that may work for you. I'm a bigger guy. I tried carrying appendix, it's very uncomfortable. I tried carrying it before I had my firearm CCW license, and I tried it after. Not comfortable for me. I do carry on the hip, and I found that to be the most comfortable. Two recommendations on holsters that I chose for myself were the Black Arch Protos-M holster, which is a hybrid holster that has great retention and still has the comfort of having a leather holster. There's also the Black Arch Entrada holster. I did a video on that. And I think that's a great holster for someone new that wants to just spend one amount of money but be able to have multiple options for carrying that holster. You can convert it from an appendix holster with a sidecar to hold a magazine. You can convert it to just being a solo appendix holster. You can also use it for your carrying on your hip and on your back. It's convertible. It's great. I don't use that one. I actually use the Protos-M. That feels comfortable for me, being a larger guy. It fits comfortable, feels great, and that's what I enjoy right now. So look and research on holsters, purchase one, use it, carry it, you know, wear it. Another thing is your clothing. You don't have to get tactical clothing. You don't have to go to 5-Eleven, which their clothes are great. You don't have to go to all these other, you know, online stores to purchase your firearm, your carry clothes that all these cool guys have. They look great. They probably feel great, but you do not need that. You know, go to Target, Walmart, whatever you wear, just order a size bigger in your pants, size or two, and you'll be good. You'll be fine. You don't need to spend that extra money. Also, get a good carry belt, a good EDC belt. I happen to go with Nick's belt. I use it every day. I used it for work. I use it for my carry. I use it for day to day. Great belt, has a lot of stiffness, but still flexible for day to day comfort. Great company, they're local. One thing I like to do is support local California companies. So Nick's belt is great for that. I've worn my belt for probably 2 years now. Haven't had any issues with it wearing away. Haven't had any issues with it falling apart. With the next belt, it has a ratcheting system that allows you to adjust quick and on the fly. So look into that. I'm just giving you my opinions and what I use. But do your own research. Pick what you want. But I like to go with local companies. You also wanted to look up and find a good travel safe. For me, I use the Voltex Life Pod. I use that as my carry safe. I use it as my nightstand safe. Pretty much that thing goes with me everywhere I go. You never know when you become a CCW holder where there's going to be a location here in California that actually might have a sticker that says no firearms allowed. I go to the post office a lot. You're not allowed to carry in the post office. So I had that safe ready. So once I got my license, it was with me all the time. A good place in Orange County, we are talking about Orange County CCWs, is Max Safes in Santa Ana. Great company, great people there. They carry all the Voltex lines. You don't have to order it. It's there on hand. That's where I pick up my stuff from. So go check them out if you want to buy anything small, big, large, custom. They have everything there. That's just my recommendation on where I would go. Other than that, there's not too much really to think about. You know, just make sure you take a good carry, a good CCW class. There's a lot of people that will tell you, take the most expensive, take the most, you know, educating class for your CCW class. And this is for people who haven't taken their CCW class yet. But I recommend taking a class that's going to give you the basics and the basic knowledge of carrying and not flooding you with other information like how to shoot on the floor, how to shoot on the move. When you're going for your CCW class, you want to learn and educate yourself on the rules and the laws, and you want a good class that does that. You don't want something that's going to put you through all these different scenarios, which are great. I love it. But for your CCW class, I would focus on a class that's just going to focus on the laws and regulations for your CCW. That is very important. You know, you can, you know, when a situation happens, a lot of the training kind of goes out the window. But you are going to need to know what your rights are and what you're able to do before you pull that firearm. Then second, after you take your CCW classes, I then recommend you taking a class that will teach you technique, teach you different scenarios. Have that as a separate class. I'm not saying don't take a class like that. I'm saying have that as a separate class. Learn that stuff separately once you are comfortable with your knowledge. Because if you get knowledge and you realize, oh, this is not for me, you didn't want to have spent your money on some other class that's too much. I recommend taking classes all the time, doing your due diligence and getting, you know, educated with the firearm you're using. So that is very important as well. Take classes, but when you're taking your CCW class, find a class that's going to be focusing purely on laws, rules, and regulations. And then right immediately after, then take a self-defense class, take a carry class, take a shooting and moving class, whatever you may feel that you need to do to get yourself better familiarized with your firearm, do it. Other than that, you know, be patient. The system right now in Orange County is doing as best it can to get you your interviews, to get you your license. Once you have your interview, you get your license pretty quick. As long as you know you have nothing wrong in your background, you're going to be pretty good, and the interview process goes really smooth. So don't worry about that. Just worry about the things you need to do before you get your license. Because once you get your license and you start carrying, you're part of the 0.3%, and you're now putting yourself in a situation where you can defend yourself if need be. Like all of us, we hope not to, but we are prepared to defend ourselves. So with that said, guys, thank you guys for watching. Please like, subscribe, and if you're looking to get carry insurance, please use my link in the bio or click the link on my banner on my page, and they'll direct you to USCCA and help support my channel, help me grow my channel, and thank you guys for watching. Peace.